In this video, we're going to show you how to change the color of flow items and objects in your model. Let's quickly create a sample model. Drag out a source, a queue, a processor, and a sink, and connect them starting with the source all the way down to the sink. There are two ways to change the colors of items and objects in FlexSim, the first of which is easier but less dynamic. Click on any of the four objects in the model, and that object's quick properties will appear on the right side pane. Toward the top, you'll see a rectangle of color representing the color of the object you've selected. By using the sampler, which has an eyedropper icon to the right, you can select a new color by clicking on any bit of color in FlexSim or any place in Windows. Keep in mind your first click after selecting the sampler will set the color to whatever the cursor is pointed at. You can also click the black arrow to select a color from the chart. The items that move throughout the model can also be colored. Click on Tools and then Flow Item Bin in the menu bar to find a list of flow items in the model. Choose an item and change its color in the Quick Properties menu just as you did before. Be aware that using this method will make all flow items of that class the same color throughout the entire duration of the model. In order to have objects and items change color dynamically while the model is running, you have to use triggers. Double-click on the processor to open its properties window and go to the Triggers tab. Add an event to the OnEntry trigger and select Set Item Type and Color. The default option for this trigger assigns an item type between 1 and 3 to every item and gives it a color corresponding to the item type. Change the range from open paren 1, 3 close paren to open paren 1, 20 close paren so we can have a larger color pool to choose from. But what if we want to change the color of the processor as well? Add another event to the OnEntry trigger and select Set Color. By default, it will change an item's color based on the item type, but we want it to change the color of the processor, not the items that pass through it. This can easily be done using the sampler. Double-click on the word item in the function colorArray to highlight it. Click the sampler, and then click the processor. The sampler has done the work for you, correctly referencing itself within the setColor trigger by inserting current in place of item. Click Reset and run the model. Every time an item enters the processor, both the item and the processor change to a color that is determined by the random item type assigned by the trigger. Thank you for watching. For more information on FlexSim products or to view more tips and tricks for successful modeling, please visit www.flexsim.com.